Larrivee guitars, how exciting. Brand new for Coleman's music.
Very exciting.
Yeah. These originated in Canada for everyone playing at home that didn't already know that. Doesn't sound Canadian because they're not made in Canada.
Unless you're French Canadian, you're like, of course it sounds Canadian.
Yeah.
That was my French Canadian accent.
That was not bad. I mean, I'd probably give you like a 2.
Yeah, thanks, man.
Yeah. Anyway, these are now made in California, same as bloody most other guitars.
Yeah, well, thanks to the GFC, they closed up the Canadian factories and they moved all this stuff to California.
Is that?
Well, they opened in California in 2001 or something like that. And then
GFC, was it?
They closed down after the GFC, apparently. So, like 2012, something like that.
Right.
They closed down wherever they were in Canada at the time.
Ah.
Vancouver, Toronto.
Vancouver, right.
There's a bit of history. Read their website if you want a lot of it. Or watch a video on Jean-Claude Larrivee. It's actually quite fascinating because the dude's like all guitar builders, you know,
he's
one of those wood nuts. They're all wood nuts. They love wood. Seriously. Anyway. Is that going to be weird? Is that the wrong term to use for this thing?
No, I think woodnut is the right term to use for sure. Anyway, what do we got here?
We've got a couple of I don't know whether you call this traditional. That's traditional.
Yeah.
You know, that's kind of...
It's like a parlor shape.
Yeah. It's a big parlor shape, though.
Yeah, long.
So that's a 00040.
Cool. 00040RE.
Yeah, so it's right. Rosewood, right?
Yeah.
Beautiful
rosewood back in size.
That's got beautiful purple stripes right there.
It's cool.
So if you're watching this video, pray that you want to buy that guitar, pray that you get that one, because that's gorgeous.
Yeah, it's sick. Sitka spruce top.
Mm.
You've got bold rope binding and as well as obviously
maple trim, yeah.
Yeah.
Maple, and the maple all around the neck's really good as well. I like the way they've done that. So the fretboards are all bound in maple.
Yeah, and it feels amazing. Like the neck's super silky and smooth.
Has that one got like a flat sort of neck, or a wide and?
It feels pretty flat. Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah. The model of this one?
This is an O-40. So this is a very small guitar. That's 25 and a half inch scale length. This is 24.
Yeah.
So this is a little guitar. So if you're looking for a little guitar and a really good one, this is worth looking at. Not only that, it's absolutely gorgeous.
Yeah, it's
again,
cool.
You know, all the same things, right? So we've got the rosewood back and sides, the same sort of binding. So that same rope, what do you call it?
Bold rope.
There you go.
Bold rope.
Tortoiseshell scratch plate, you know, the ebony and the little same inlays, the little diamonds and
For all the traveling troubadours out there, this is the perfect guitar for that. Isn't it?
Look at it. It's just cool.
And it sounds really great unplugged as well, which a lot of small guitars don't. But we'll stick it right in front of it and tick. Yeah.
And then you know the open style machine heads. So for somebody who wants. You know, something else, they kind of focus. Anyway, close up on it later on.
They also have some nice like little detailing.
Yeah, I was going to say some really cool sort of detailing.
Looks like laser etched detailing on the buttons or something, isn't it? It's cool. Yeah. What else? LR bags, element pickup systems in both of them.
Yep. So real again, you know, given the style of guitar this is, you know, you haven't got a gigantic preamp thing on there, which. Some people don't want.
Just a little hidden volume control.
Yeah. Yeah, and the guitar, you know, looks like it did in 1930, even though Jean-Claude Larrivee didn't start making until 1967.
80s or something?
67.
Oh, was it? Really?
It says 67. There you go.
Okay, there you go. Yeah, but like, obviously, like, just probably the biggest selling point for these, for me, is like, just how smooth they are. It's like all satin.
Yeah.
And, it's just silk.
Yeah.
It's crazy.
Yeah, you've got to come in and play one of these, or if you're just watching, just know that these are clean fretboards. They're easy to get your hands around.
Yeah.
And
the whole thing is, like, flawless. Like, it's just, like, you can't find a fault.
Yeah, I was looking before, trying to find, like, something where, like, the wood's not right or the glue's not...
Even like looking in the sound hall, even looking at the bracing, like all of the bracing is just like clean as crazy. So come in and check them out. We're going to have a play of both of them now and give you some sound samples.
Stick around. Thank you.